Ladies and gentlemen, making his way to the ring area, he is the WCW World Cruiserweight Champion, the Disco Inferno.
Oh, look at this. He's at least gracing us with the WCW Cruiserweight belt this week.
The night with the Inferno never loses. They never lose on Saturday night.
Well, Disco Inferno last week, legend, you weren't here. Mike today was my broadcast partner, and Disco would not wear the belt out because it clashed with his ring attire. Can you beat that?
Reminds me of Bockwinkle.
He does?
Well, he used to wear the belt under his clothes. He slept in the belt, but then if it clashed, he wouldn't wear it. Very weird individual.
You know, you're interrupting Disco.
Both of them.
Now, I know everybody came to see the Disco Inferno dance.
I, for one, did not.
I don't care if I interrupt the punk.
But in less than two short weeks, I have become known as the greatest cruiserweight champion of all time.
That's who?
I am better than Kidman. I am better than Rey Mysterio Jr. I am better than Eddie Guerrero. Pounds. So tonight, since the cruiserweight division provides no competition for the Disco Inferno, I'm gonna wrestle a heavyweight. So get your tush out here and dance with the Disco Inferno.
Who's he talking to?
I don't know.
The tush thing.
Oh, let's not reinforce that at all, please. Who's this heavyweight gonna be? Disco stepping out of his weight class. Wait a minute.
And his opponent, from parts unknown, the Disciple.
Go get him, Scott. This is right up your alley.
It's him. It's Dizzy Brutus Boulder, the Beefcake Zodiac, Booty Butcher Barber Disciple, the man with no name. I can't believe it.
Hey, this guy's got more lives than a cat. And he's still out there wiggling.
Speaking of cat, I think a cat got hold of his jacket. Disco.
No, it was Disco.
Putting the forearms to the back of the Disciple. Oh, he's opening up on the veteran. Disco, no, reversal. Disco into the corner. Nice hip toss. Heel throw by the Disciple. Running lariat. Leveled it. Oh, the Disciple trying to send a statement here. Oh, Disco bailed.
But that's the smartest thing he could have done. Disciple got him a good one underneath the chin. And like we said, he's no cruiserweight. He's got a lot more weight put underneath that blow than Disco was. Disco's got some good movement here. He's coming a long way in the last few years. I mean, getting that cruiserweight belt was not an easy thing to do.
Certainly not. The most competitive division in WCW right now is the cruiserweight division. And at Halloween Havoc, old D.I., the mighty D.I., Disco Inferno, will defend it against Lash LaRue, whom we saw earlier in an impressive victory. Barring that left arm of Disco Inferno is the Disciple. Disciple, long time, even a childhood friend of Hulk Hogan. And at Halloween Havoc, Hulk Hogan gets a shot at the 10 pounds of gold one more time.
I tell you, not only a shot at the gold, I think a chance to wake Sting up from his dark sleep or whatever is going through his mind. We all have ups and downs in our lives, and believe me, I've seen better and stronger men than Sting crack in less time, but sometimes in life, you gotta hit the bottom before you can appreciate the top.
Well, who better to tell you that than the Disciple? We have seen Ed Leslie, the Disciple, over the last few years, reinvent himself several times. Hence the long moniker we hung on him earlier in this match.
Oh, he's in trouble here. He kicked out. I mean, he's a big, strong guy, but again, an identity crisis when, you know, you want to be the best there is, and you want to be that superstar. And for the Disciple here, being a close friend of Hulk Hogan, how do you fill a pair of shoes? That thing, almost an impossible feat for this guy, so hence his identity crisis.
Sunset left. Uh-oh. Disciple cradles him up, and Disco kicks out at two.
I think due to his close friend.
Maybe so. I don't disagree with that theory, legend. I think you're exactly right. Disco putting the boots to the Disciple in the corner. Disco, I don't think taking on a veteran and a heavyweight is the best way to prepare for the youngster cruiserweight Lash LaRue. Disco's not thinking. What else is there?
It's not that, and you've got to wrestle them all. Big men, little men, fast men, you know, brawlers, wrestlers. The more you wrestle, the more you learn. It's just that simple. There is no easy way. You cannot learn this by watching videos.
Certainly not. Disco into the ropes. He's going to drop down. Fist right to the top of the head. Referee Mickey J lets it go. Got a two count. Disco did on the Disciple. Now reverse chinlock on the veteran. And Disco Inferno winning the Cruiserweight Championship less than 2 weeks ago on WCW Nitro from Psychosis. And Psychosis losing the match within a week, winning that Cruiserweight Championship, but losing it less than 2 days later for the Disco Inferno. Side rush and leg sweep. Disco should really be worrying about a pinfall here.
He should be laying on top of the Disciple. Now he's wasting time. I don't know if it's going to pay off or not. This is a gamble here.
And he's also spending too much time dancing on the metal turnbuckle. Disciple maybe playing a little possum. Anyone? Disco missed with the elbow drop. The Cruiserweight Champion. Whoa, got taken down by the running lariat. Two from the Disciple. Disco slowly back up to his feet. Disciple quickly over. Look at his feet. High knee. High knee from the Disciple. That may be it.
Got that knee up there. Okay, Disco's wobbly.
High cross body. This may be it. Lateral press.
Oh, he snuck out of it.
Oh, Disco barely out at two. Oh, would that have brought him down a couple of pegs had he lost it to the Disciple? Oh, front face DDT. This may be it. Feet first. Disco went down too. Oh, and Disco, I mean, just barely got his boot across that lower rope.
Yeah, he lucked out right there. The Disciple, a little bit hasty, but too close to the rope. Disco took advantage of it, but he's still in trouble. Well, he slipped off of him.
There we go. The last dance. Oh, did that have impact? The last dance. Two and three, Disco Inferno.
And your winner, the WCW Cruiserweight Champion, the Disco Inferno.
Well, he's ready for Halloween Havoc and Lash LaRue. That was a hard-fought contest, make no mistake about it.
I tell you, not easy. Disco won the belt, but secret with the Cruiserweights, how long can he keep it?
Halloween Havoc brought to you by Slim Jim is October 24th. The world strap, it's Hogan and Sting.